timer.
Cool.
Let's head over to...
see you later.
There we go.
We've got round four, game one. You've done it.
Yep, did that bit already. So we don't know what these guys are playing, except that because they're 3-0, it's presumably reasonably good.
And as ever, I'm willing to take calls on unofficial names for decks if anyone comes up with a good one. Otherwise, they might just be pretty vague. You're not typing.
Oh, no. There we go.
Ah. Good stuff? Yeah, sure.
All right, so yeah, these players are battling out for extra packs. Everyone who comes to a pre-release gets at least a pack, but if you win more, you'll get some more packs.
Mm-hmm. just while
and
doing
of course
it.
There's Glory as well. Glory is good.
We do have a Pokemon Winter pre-release coming up on 22nd of January. If anyone's watching who's a Pokemon player, that'll be heading off on 22nd.
Yeah,
so date for your diary.
You'll be able to get the new Sun and Moon set.
Okay, so we've got some
green white.
And some green white.
Ooh. Okay.
And so green white good stuff and green white good stuff.
Well, we don't know about the quality of the stuff yet.
Okay, so we're still leaving a question mark in.
Should we just put green white stuff? Or are we going to. Yeah, okay. Who has the most good stuff? Oh, he's got a Bristling Hydra. James has a Bristling Hydra. So that is.
So we can take, we could probably take away the question mark.
Yeah, he has played a turn two elf that taps for mana, whose name I cannot remember, which means he's going to get a turn three Bristling Hydra. Yikes, that is
pretty bonkers.
That is tough to beat.
But as Brenton's in white, yeah, we can assume as he's got this far, he's probably, yeah, he's got Caught in the Brights there, I can see in his hand. So if he holds that back, that's going to be pretty good for
him.
Yeah,
I mean, the Hydra's ability, you can pay three mana to give it a +1/+1 counter and hexproof until end turn, and it gives you three energy when it enters. So you need two removal spells to get rid of it, and that's assuming that James doesn't have another way to get energy. And that's highlighted one of my favourite cards for limited that I've played with so far. That is the Druid of the Cowl, which is the 2-drop that James played, which allowed him to play the Hydra on turn 3. Accelerating your mana is super powerful, regardless of what the format is like. That's just a 2-2 flyer there for James, which doesn't match up well against Brendan's Aerial Responder. But
it's another dude.
He's got the Hydra, so
yeah. Brendan's swinging in.
Yeah, Responder be having Vigilance and Lifelink is very nice. It means that Brendan's gonna be able to survive for quite some time, even if he takes four from this Hydra every turn. Brendan is gonna need to find an answer to his Hydra at some point. His answer may be just playing a bigger creature. That is awkward. You can grow the Hydra. A Fairgrounds Trumpeter.
But then if he uses the ability to grow the Hydra, I mean, Brendan's going to be aware of the Hydra's ability. So if James decides to use the ability to grow the Hydra, at that point, assuming James doesn't have more energy, Brendan can decide he's going to Caught It in the Brights.
Yeah, Brendan had the choice there. He could double block the Hydra. His Fairgrounds Trumpeter is a 3-mana 2-2. It can get counters on itself if you put counters on your other things.
Okay, so...
So that he could block it with 4 power there.
Not entirely sure what life went.
He has declined to do so, though. Ooh, that gets...
So we're on less life than 18. I know we are. It's just Brendan's neglected to turn his life counter down.
Yeah, James has got two of these Druids of the Cowls. That's nice. He's out of gas now. He's just got a Plains in hand. But he's got quite a lot of gas in play, so... what is that other creature he's just played there? That is...
Right.
Oh, that's a Maul Fist Revolutionary.
And
by
James
looks of it.
Is coming to the rescue by changing the life counter for me, so I can accurately do everyone's life.
Yeah, so Maul Fist Revolutionary is a 3-mana 3/3 with Trample. When it enters the battlefield or dies, for each kind of counter on a permanent or player, you can give that permanent or player another counter. So James himself got another energy from that. He elected not to put a counter on his Hydra and give the Hydra another counter, perhaps anticipating a removal spell from Brendan. Oh no, this is a nice card from Brendan. Certainly got constructed applications. The Renegade Rallier, 3 mana, 3-2, Revolt. When it enters the battlefield, if a permanent you control has left the battlefield this turn, you can return a permanent with mana cost 2 or less from your graveyard to the battlefield. In Modern, you can get back fetch lands.
That's cool.
That's a pretty good way of ramping your mana.
That's a pretty good thing to do.
Yeah. Interesting card. And it looks like Brendan's got quite a good Revolt deck here. He's just played a Hidden Herbalist, which is a 2-mana 2-2. If you can get the Revolt trigger, that gives you a green-green when it enters the battlefield.
Okay, I'm swinging in.
Nice, yeah. James is...
double-blocking.
No, not a bad trade there for James. He's got plenty of mana. You've got to be careful about trading with your opponent, though, in this format, given that Revolt is a thing. Oh, nice. That's going to gain 5 life for airdrop aeronaut, from airdrop aeronauts for
Brendan.
Brendan's
gone up to 23.
There you go. And that only triggered because James traded off. Yeah, we can see James is flooding out here. He's got 2 lands in hand. He's attacking. He doesn't mind if he loses his this guy because it'll get him another energy counter. I wonder how many ways Brendan has of triggering his fairground trumpeter. You only need to put 1 counter on it before it becomes a pretty good card. Very good, Rachael. Revolting stuff indeed. James has got knocked down to 8 there, while Brendan's up to 22. Oh, wow. We've seen this card end the game already. This is the Walking Ballista. That's actually... that can force James to use the Hydra's ability. And, yeah, there we go. No, I think you're right there, okay. Zafri 7. Aerial Responder really kept Brendan in the game there. Just so good in a race. As a blocker, gaining you 2 life and getting in for 2 damage.
Well, that was a quick game.
Yeah, it's the white there. Vampire Nighthawk, which is funny because black gets its own new Vampire Nighthawk in this set.
So we go, the first game over in under 10 minutes. So
yeah, no, it's...
Moving quickly, these guys.
Yeah, and not the result you'd expect after seeing the first 3 turns of the game.
indeed.
Yeah, Brendan getting
it back.
It. Does he have? Is that an Angel of Invention in his deck?
It yes, is. It is. It is. Angel. Wow.
Good grief. Well,
looks like Brendan has a sweet deck.
Yeah, though. I mean, yeah, we've not seen any +1/+1 counters really. So, that trumpeter might just be his 23rd card.
Okay, and James is looking to sideboard.
He's got an aerial maneuver there. Lets him flicker a creature, exile and return it. But doesn't look like he's going for it. Does aerial maneuver only target your own creatures? It probably does. But I'm going to check that, because otherwise you'd be able to use it to destroy Walking Ballista. Yeah, it's acrobatic maneuver, sorry. Yeah, exiles a creature you control, returns it to the battlefield, and then you draw a card.
Okay, shuffling up.
Right, yeah, we had some pretty fast rounds. We tried to pick dirtly decks, but...
Apparently not.
Yeah. I wonder if green white is maybe the stronger archetype in this format.
Well, I could see it being so. I mean, green has got the big things you need. White has some removal and also the sky things, the flyers as they're more commonly known. So I could imagine that green white has got the sort of vanilla stuff that you need in limited.
Yeah, and certainly in Aether Revolt, white gets quite a few removal spells, doesn't it? So
yeah,
removal and big creatures is a winning formula.
Mm. Yeah, I think one thing that we can learn is that although it's super fun and super tempting to make silly decks, sometimes what all you want is just like a solid does the thing well deck, right?
Yeah, well, that's how these guys got to 3-0. All right, here we're going. James will be on the play this time, which means it gives him another opportunity at getting a turn
Brendan
3 Hydra.
Brendan has no land hand there, so he'll be going down to 6.
Okay. 6 on the draw.
And better now that we have the scry, of course.
Yes, that's not so bad. But James has kept his. I wonder if he's got another Druid of the Cowl to accelerate out something nasty.
Hmm.
So we've still got this Zebra to give out.
Yeah, I know. I feel like Brendan so far has impressed me as a... The deck that looked like it was on the back foot the most but came back. But then a lot of you have been watching since the start. I mean, do you guys have a favourite deck we've seen? If you do, put it in the comments. That'd be ace.
My vote is definitely for Jason's.
Oh, yeah. No.
That was some good
that was
dirdling.
Super cool.
I like that. Those shenanigans are great.
Okay, so lots of land.
Oh, he's got the Walking Ballista, though, James. Cool. That's nice. I wonder what turn he's going to choose to play that. So Walking Ballista costs XX, so you can run it out on turn 2 if you want. But it's just going to be a 1-1. So James may choose to delay that. Oh, he also has an Arborback Stomper, I think it's called.
Okay, he has a Corner Brights as well, so if Brendan's going to be playing lots of creatures, he can maybe hold them back for a while he gets that.
Yeah, it's not very, it doesn't match up very well against the Walking Ballista, but it does match up nicely against James's Arborback Stomper, which is just a 5-mana 5/4 trample. Nice clean answer to that. And it looks like James isn't running out the Walker on turn 2. Okay, first spell of the game. That's a vehicle. That is the one that lets you untap things.
Hello to our new viewers
Mobile
on
Garrison.
Viewers on Facebook coming in.
Hello, so, Facebook.
Hi,
guys.
Facebook. Nice to see you.
Oh, James is his own aerial responder. These guys have very similar decks, don't they?
Mm. Just solid, good decks, it looks like. Walking Ballista was best kill. Jason Servo making was best deck to watch. Yes, I think I agree. Yeah. The
But does the Zebra go to the winner or to the combos?
I mean, in my head tells me the winner, but my heart calls to the combos.
So that aerial responder is not sticking around. That's exiled. By Thopter Arrest. Brendan does not want that sticking around. Here we go, it's a Walking Ballista X's 2. So you can pay 4 mana to put another counter on this guy, and given that you can take a counter off to do 1 damage to something, that effectively means you have 4 mana, do a damage at your disposal. Doesn't seem that'll be massively useful against Brendan's deck, because it looks like it's more big creatures.
Big things doing big stuff.
Yeah, rather than servos. But this Ballista is definitely a good card regardless. Right, so Brendan's just considering his play here on turn 5. He only has 1 green mana. Can't quite get a close enough look at his hand to tell if that's a problem for him yet.
I think he's actually just got a lot of options at the moment from what I've seen.
Yeah, so he runs out his airdrop aeronauts. He doesn't gain 5 life from them, but it's still a 4-3 flyer, so he can't be too picky. I guess James could do 3 damage to it with his walker if he wanted. Pay 4 to put a counter on it, and then take 3 off to deal 3 damage. That is sort of putting the ball in Brendan's court there, as Brendan will be the first to untap and play onto a empty board.
I mean, both players are being a lot more cautious this game. I think they're both aware that they can flood the board quickly if they want to. I'm waiting for the other player to make the move before they do.
So it looks like James's plan is just to put another counter on his walker. Hey, there we go. So we've got a 3-3 walker facing down a 2-2. Okay, now this is interesting. Who's going to pull the trigger? I guess Brendan's walker could respond to that. Yeah, in response, do a damage, and then if that resolves, do another damage. Actually, that wouldn't work. They would both self-destruct there.
So why has James has gone up to 3 here?
So James has just activated the ability of the Walking Ballista. You can pay 4 mana to put a counter on it. Oh, okay, that's interesting. So James could actually have removed a counter in response there to kill Brendan's one, which would result in them both going down. Which is a bit of a weird play, but it can be done. I suppose Brendan's probably going to do 1 damage to James here. There we go. Yeah, these guys are just matching each other card for card, right? Yeah, I'd quite like to play with a Walking Ballista. I was lucky enough to open a Hangerback Walker in my Origins pre-release, and that was good fun. That's a very hard card for people to beat.
Okay, swing in.
There we go. He's choosing to put a counter on with Fabricate, and then smashing in for some damage.
Okay, and James takes that. Of course, he's tapped out, and he's gone down to
Iron League Steed that Brendan played. 4 mana, 2-2, haste, Fabricate 1.
James is on 6 life. That's 6, right?
That's a glint sleeve artisan there. Nice.
Could be 8.
Gets James a couple of blockers.
Gets 8.
Yeah, looks like an 8 to me.
Yeah.
Ooh, this guy's once again showing what he's made of, the Dawnfeather Eagle. Really helps push through damage. We've seen that before today. Just the fact that it comes attached to a 3-3 flyer as well means that this isn't just a one-turn trick. That Dawnfeather Eagle is going to be relevant for as long as it's around. Oh, here we go.
So is that...
That is going to allow him to exile and return his creature to the battlefield. That's Acrobatic Maneuver. I believe so, if I've got that right. Or was that a Sky Whaler shot, maybe?
I thought it might have been something different. Okay, so we've got that's the tiger there, isn't it?
Oh, no, that's not the tiger. That is the Arborback Stomper.
There he is.
Gains 5 life for James, bringing up to 8. And it's a 5-4 trample. I think Brendan has in his hand a Caught in the Brights. Yeah, it could have been Alley Evasion, actually. Though the Glint Sleeve Artisan is now in the graveyard.
Yep. Yeah. Gary seems to think it's Alley Evasion.
Yeah, fair enough. Well, I'll believe him. so I imagine that, yeah, it's going to be caught,
caught
in the brights.
In the brights. And then we're going to swing in.
That is for 7 in the air. James can't do much there.
Gone down to 1.
Yep, James is going to have to draw something good here. Ooh, and...
whereas we could have another...
another creature. So it's going to have to be good in the sense of sort of fumigate is kind of what we're looking at here.
No, that wasn't it. Well, he's got a caught in the brights.
Gets rid of one.
Then he's only got one damage to go.
Then he's got a chump blocker. No, he's got... Is that prey upon? Okay. He might be okay here. Yeah. He can take out one this way.
Yeah, caught in the brights. Flyer. The good other. Plan.
Nice. Yeah, and then he's got...
he's got a chumper.
He's got a chump blocker. And then he has a creature next turn, which will be another... you can't see what creature it is. It's either a chump blocker or it'll be a regular blocker. I think Brendan drew a land there, so...
Bye-bye, Survey. Hardly
nice. This is down to top deck, so James is going to have to run better than Brendan here. Okay, if you can play 2 spells in a turn, that's going to... get him back in the game.
Okay, so that's the monkey.
Yep, that's a cat monkey. Cannot see what the other card in his hand is. It doesn't look like it is a creature then. Though I could be wrong. There we go, another monkey. A good way of triggering revolt, by the way.
Okay, yeah, hand to the bus.
Gonna trade. James is gonna have to lay something down again. Go on, he needs another blocker or a removal spell.
Okay, so what do we have?
That looks like a blocker, I think. 5 mana.
Nope, 4 mana.
Nice. I'm going to have to... Is that the guy who gets you energy? I think it might be. Yeah, that is Pima Aethersir. 4 mana, 3/2. When it enters battlefield, you get energy equal to the greatest power among creatures you control. So in this case, it's going to be 3. And you can also pay 3 mana to force a creature to block this turn.
That's pretty cool.
It is, however, likely to just...
sit there and go trade, under the bus.
Yeah, trade with this cat monkey. Brendan doesn't look too happy. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no, double lands in hand.
No, he's going to pass. See, I think attacking there is better, forcing James to trade. But
especially if he's sitting on 2 lands.
Yeah.
To force James to trade there means, he's on a higher life total.
Oh, I know.
He's got longer time.
This is the weird enchantment, isn't it? So this is the one with a revolt. So this is Aid from the Cowl. So 5 mana enchantment, revolt. At the beginning of your end step, if a permanent you control left the battlefield this turn...
Okay, now they've traded.
Yeah. Then you can reveal the top card of your library. If it's a permanent, you can put it on the battlefield.
There it is.
There we go. Oh, yeah, so I think... Yeah, Brendan, I think, should have attacked on his turn there. By blocking on James's turn, he allowed James to trigger revolt. So James may
be still
get back
here
into the game this way.
Oh, but course, it's another land.
You never know. Brendan may have another walking ballista. Just top deck it and finish James off with 1 damage.
So we've got 2 very similar decks, both staring down at each other, both holding lands. Brendan's got the higher life total, but at the moment, James has got the board presence.
Is that Angel of Invention? Oh, gosh.
Okay, so there we go. So there's probably what you needed to see.
Oh, gosh.
Just slam that down.
Yeah, your opponent's on 1. You probably make servos here. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So can he get... No. That's game. It's got to be.
He's passing the turn. He's got 3 lands in hand. When it comes to top decking, Angel is likely to beat you.
Yeah, GG. So there we go. Brendan Edwards is our champ for the evening.
Yeah, 2 very good decks here. They had a good mix of removal and some good creatures as well. Nice. All right. Well, we'll have a quick chat with Brendan and see how he feels about being victorious.
Good, I hope.
Yeah, you'd hope so. And then we have to decide who's getting this
yeah,
zebra.
Yeah, help. Help, guys. Who's getting our zebra? I personally think it should be Johnny.
Jason?
Jason. Yeah, Jason. No. I meant Jason, I said Johnny.
No, I vote for Jason as well.
We could get him in after we've talked to Brendan to award him his zebra.
Yeah, absolutely.
Which I'm sure he'll be very, very thrilled to bits.
Oh, wow, if you look, James has got a Sky Sovereign in his deck as well.
Wow.
that's a pretty hard card to beat. Jeez. That's just a Fabricate guy, isn't it? How much to crew is Sky Sovereign? I think it's 3. So not the easiest to crew. But given, yeah, crew 3, but given that you get to do 3 damage, likely kill a creature when it attacks, well worth it.
There you go, just sharing decks, what they look like. Oh, he had an Ajani. Casually had an Ajani in there as well.
Who had the Ajani?
Brendan has an Ajani.
Oh, nice. Wow, Ajani and Angel. Sometimes, yeah.
Sometimes you just get the bombs, don't you? Sometimes you just do.
Yeah, but no. Brendan's got the stuff to fill out the deck as well.
Well, yeah,
bombs.
Bearing in mind, like, yeah, the Angel helped him close out that game at the end, but it wasn't the Angel or Ajani that helped him win those 2 games, really.
Yeah, then if you look at...
James's green is ridiculous, apparently.
Yeah, he's got 2 Druid of the Cowl. I really rate that very highly. And, yeah, he's got just some big, beefy creatures, yeah. Oh, he's got the Long Tusk Cub as well. Really cool 2-drop that can get out of hand. Oh, and he's got the other vehicle, the Aether Revolt one. Oh, I'll just get it up here. It's a 3-5 with crew 1. How does that thing have crew 1? That's insane. 3-5. Aether Sphere Harvester. Looks like James had in his deck there. To go along with a Sky Sovereign. Now, those are rares you want to open. And the Walking Ballista. You want to open them because they're going to go into any deck you build, pretty much. As long as you've got a few creatures in there, right? I'm sure you can stretch to crew 1. And
yeah.
Sky Sovereign is worth...
Yeah, certainly. Me too, Zephyr. It's been interesting hanging back and watching them lay them out for each other, actually. I'm quite glad I didn't jump out just now, because seeing the decks in total, you can see why they're top table. Definitely.
Looks like these guys, James and Brendan, are both working out this walking ballista scenario again. it is possible for James to have killed off Brendan so that they both would have been destroyed.
It might have been a small problem in their relationship, but they might have got through the ballista issue, I agree, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
Like, we can get through the ballista issues.
Ballista gate.
Hashtag ballista.
I mean, I don't feel that was a pun that was worth the pufferfish, so I'm glad we've given that to Alex. And
yeah, definitely.
That was definitely. That was just a simple mistake as opposed to a...
and also, like...
something more fundamental.
Alex is one... I feel like the promise, as we were given it,
yeah,
added to the bomb.
No, certainly how he described it, I could see how it could have been amazing, but... Alex didn't have a chance against an aggro deck.
I'll go grab Brendan then, I guess. I think he's...
Yeah, you have a chat with Brendan.
So far.
We'll have a little interview with him, and I'll just switch back to the booth. Hello, I'm here. Hat is not sitting very well. Look how creased it is. That's really bad. Oh, well... there we go. Let's bring up some of the key cards. So, from this matchup, where do we have him? The mighty Aerial Responder, the Vampire Nighthawk of Kaladesh, except for the more Vampire Nighthawkish Vampire Nighthawk of Kaladesh, which would be... this fellow here, Gifted Aether Bun.
Yeah, but like, you decked what you needed to. It was like the revenge of the top decks.
Yeah. Okay.
Right, Brendan.
Okay.
Come have a seat.
You know what?
I'm going to
fix the problem we've had before. I'm going to bring this. There you go.
We can all be seen.
We can all be seen.
Nice. So, congratulations, Brendan.
Thank you very much.
Well done.
Thank you.
That was like a mirror match, wasn't it? That was weird.
Yeah, both green white, sort of.
good stuff, really, like creatures and it's good. It's
yeah,
good.
we did actually have you labelled as green, white, good stuff for both
yeah.
of you.
Yeah,
you seem to have a revolt, maybe sub-theme rather than theme,
yeah,
just from the cards that we saw.
Sort of, well, Adrani's obviously, you didn't get to see Adrani, I don't think.
No,
Adrani's in there.
You saw him when you laid it on the table
yeah.
afterwards, we got
yeah.
a glimpse.
Angel of Invention was huge at the end.
Yeah.
Just like, he's got some blockers. Oh, great, three creatures in one.
Yeah.
So that was pretty nice.
That's
I was starting to think,
yeah.
am I going to get there? He's on one, I'm on 20, like, am I going to win? But,
yeah, he started pulling back there,
yeah.
like just being able to top deck creatures and that
yeah.
turn where you got two removal spells down
yeah.
to take care of your
guys.
That
was quite interesting what me and James were talking about. I don't know if you guys can hear us, but the XX guy.
Yeah, the walking blister. Yeah, we couldn't hear you talking, but
we
saw that you
we
were.
We saw you were discussing it, yeah.
So this guy.
Walking blister,
Ooh.
You can hold the cameras just
that
there.
That guy.
Bloop.
So James's was a 2-2, mine's a 3-3.
Yeah.
So I remove a counter. I would do that twice to kill his one.
Yeah.
But then we kind of talked about it after the game, and I think he could have done it to kill my one first.
Yeah,
yeah.
Absolutely.
So I remove mm. one, his goes down to one.
Mm-hmm.
I remove another one, but then in response he removes one. Is that right?
Yes.
And it would
yeah.
kill mine, and his would survive. So
and that's what we thought was.
Well, his wouldn't survive because he'd have to take a counter off his.
Okay.
Yeah,
and
you,
oh,
okay. you were both going to yeah. self-destruct. That's what we
yeah,
predicted
yeah, yeah.
to happen.
I was like, can I do this? Is it going to work? But I think it's a great card. You can play it, obviously, however many mana you want. You can go 4 mana for a 2-2.
Yeah.
The fact that it can hit creatures and players, I think it's great. So,
absolutely. We had a game on camera earlier where it seemed all was lost for... was it Andrew?
Yes.
It was Andrew, wasn't it? It all was lost
yeah.
for Andrew, and then he
yeah.
top-decked Walking Blister, and basically
yeah.
it was 8 mana,
Banana.
Do 4 damage
yes.
to your opponent,
yeah.
win the game.
And what works well with that is, if I show you, I have the green instant, which X and a green, there we go. So put X +1/+1 counters on target artifact. So if late game,
yes.
you can put 4 or 5 counters on that.
Nice.
And then ping your opponent. So it's,
yeah, that's pretty excellent.
I think
so
it works quite nice.
That's Lifecraft Awakening. So you get X counters on a vehicle or creature. It becomes a 0/0. That's pretty cool. This walker also works nicely with your trumpeter, doesn't it?
Yeah. Got some counters enabled and stuff. So it's pretty good. This obviously enables counters.
Yeah.
Sea Sculptor. He can be counters. Ajani is just
obviously excellent.
Insane. But late game, I don't
yeah.
know how you can stop him in sealed, because if
yeah.
he starts on 4, you +1/+2, then on 6, to you could maybe draw 2 or 3 cards off that.
Right.
We played against him yesterday and 2-headed giant, and he just made a board out of nothing. So
absolutely. Draws you into more creatures, more gas,
yeah.
and it can also remove their biggest threat.
Yeah, it's quite
yeah.
funny to say. Me and James both played Caught in the Brights and Fopter Arrest against
we
each
saw,
other. Like,
yeah.
The decks were like so similar.
Yeah,
but
they were crazily similar.
Well,
we did for a while. The fact that you were staring down at each other
yeah,
for so long when
yeah.
he was on one was
like
testament
wait a second,
to like, how they
I'm
were just insane, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And both having Walking Blisters is not very likely either.
I know, both having Aero Responders.
Yes.
Yeah. Pretty spicy.
Yeah, no, we've seen a lot. This is the third time we've seen Walking Blister on the camera today. And actually the second deck to have an Angel of Invention.
Yeah.
Yeah,
which
yeah,
is...
yeah. Angel is just fantastic.
Yeah.
Like, other creatures +1/+1 is so good.
Yeah, no,
so.
we though when we saw it earlier, it did lose 2 games, didn't it?
Yeah.
Did it?
Not, yeah.
I mean, it got shocked.
It certainly
someone shocked my one. Because obviously I fabricated to get the guys and
yeah.
literally only 1 toughness. So, but it's a great card. I mean, this is my third pre-release event of the weekend,
yeah.
and this deck just built itself. Like, I had
yeah.
like 10 minutes left at the end, which is so rare. I was like,
yeah.
I think it's done.
Easiest
like,
deck of the weekend, then?
Yeah, it's built itself so well. So many good creatures. Green White was fantastic.
Your best deck of the weekend?
Yes. Play 2-headed Giant, didn't do very well. Midnight on Friday went 2-1, so that's quite good.
Oh, nice.
So, promo was Yeheni. I wanted to play Yeheni, but...
Oh,
he
your promo from this one?
He's
yeah,
super
yeah.
cool,
though. He's really cool. I just thought green white looks so good.
Really hard to
I can't not get green white.
Oh yeah, from
like I
from
mean,
this
you
one.
Had the angel, you had a journey. I think like Yeheni's got to have a sleep.
Yeah,
like
yeah,
compared
sure, yeah.
to that, like
yeah. But
it's
good, good.
Super cool. By the way, Zephyr says hi and well done. Zephyr being Gary.
Gary Brown.
Yeah,
we assume Gary.
We
Brown.
Assume so.
Well,
maybe.
Thank you, Gary. That's you.
Yeah.
It's a Gary. Like,
yeah. Well, hello, Gary, out there.
Yeah, there are a few people watching.
Sweet.
All right.
So how's the stream gone so far? Are you guys getting all right?
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
It's been fun.
We've talked a lot of rubbish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a shame I can't see any, because I watched a lot yesterday with, was it Ken?
Yeah, it was Ken, Scott and Rob
as well. Yeah, so that was really cool.
Nice.
I was enjoying watching that.
Yeah, I think we'll probably stream the next pre-release as well, and maybe we might be streaming some F&Ms at some point as well.
Sweet.
So cool. Stay tuned for
that. It's pretty cool being on stage. I enjoyed it. I kept forgetting the live counter. I was like, oh yeah.
Yep.
No, I was like, I know he's taken damage, but I'm not entirely sure how much. And then James like went in the chain. I was like, James has fixed it, right? Yeah. So he's down to this. Yeah. So.
It is hard to remember. I mean, being on the stream gives you you have a couple of extra bits you have to try and remember while still playing Magic, so it's a little bit tricky. So,
lights beaming down and the pressure's on. No, it's good fun. It's good experience.
Nice.
So that's pretty sweet.
Glad you enjoyed it.
Zachary says it's me. So
hi, Gary.
Whatever that means.
Maybe not him.
Yeah, it could be anyone, right? Like,
well, he said his name is Gary.
Or? He did earlier.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
We've been assuming up till now the Gary we think it is.
misspelled my name, so maybe not Gary Brown. Maybe he doesn't know me. Maybe he does. Who knows?
Maybe he just picked a random name and we all just assumed.
Or now I'm checking. Maybe we misspelled your name.
Yeah.
No,
we're good.
No, okay, phew.
Yeah.
So, revolting stuff, I like that.
At least someone does. Like, Kieren rolled his eyes when I made that killer pun. Like,
well, I've heard it a few times this weekend.
You're not LSB, Rachel. Nearly, though.
One day.
Keep trying.
When I become LSB, I think Kieren will truly love me. But until that day, I'm just second best.
So we've been asking everyone who comes in, Brendan, what's your favourite card from the set?
Favourite card from the set?
Yeah, just to spring that on you from out of nowhere.
Well, Angel and... Where's the set, is it?
That's Kaladesh, That's old school now. That's the last set.
I think Adrani. I haven't used Adrani today. I don't know, though. This card is great. Dawnfeather Eagle.
Yeah, he's been excellent in...
So, it gives you creatures +1/+1 vigilance. So, if you've got loads of creatures, play at turn 5. Attack.
Yeah, as a common.
Every time we've seen it hit the board... Mm-hmm. It's done work, right? Mm. Not even tonight, though. Like, in every game that we've personally played as well, it has done work.
Yeah.
I think a surprisingly excellent common.
It's a great effect, and 3/3 flyers are always good in sealed, so I like it.
Yeah,
I
think it's a 3/3 flyer, but that puts it over the top, right? There's been there's often a 4-mana 3/3 in a set that does a similar effect.
There is.
And they're always okay. But then not usually as good as this one. I think this one just having such a relevant body afterwards is really good. And board stalls seem to be a thing in this format. They do seem to happen, and he breaks through quite nicely.
What else we got on the set? Heart of Kieren is great. Yeah. I had that on Friday night. Free to crew was a little bit tricky at times, but when you can crew it, 4 flying vigilance is just huge. So I think that was great.
Nice. I mean, imagine the... If you're tapping creatures to crew it with crew 3, then you're probably not going to get the most use out of the vigilance.
Yeah, I agree. I think
crewing it twice must be pretty hard.
Yeah, for sure. But then your opponent's taking 4 each turn, so that's also painful. I think standard it could be really, really good, because you can remove a loyalty from a planeswalker to crew it.
Yeah.
So if you play, for example, Gideon, you can attack and then just use it on the defense with the crewing. So
going back to our discussion about Oath of Ajani, I think it's another reason why it's not really good. Why not play this on turn 2 and then you can play your planeswalker turn 3?
Oath of Ajani, better. I mean, someone opened one today because he showed it to me when I was looking at my Ajani, and I mean, in sealed it would be amazing, but I don't know about standard.
We were having a disagreement with Alex and Matt earlier. We thought it wasn't great, they thought it was great.
What seems cool, though, is that turn 2, Gideon turn 3. I mean, Gideon turn 3 is just OP, right? Does it not make a planeswalker's 1 cheaper?
It does make them 1 cheaper, I don't know. But then you've got an unprotected Gideon turn 3, except for his knight.
But if you're turn 3 on the play, you should be, I think, all right. Yeah. Not necessarily. And also, if you play it turn 2, does the effect do nothing? Because, I guess if you have a 1-drop, you get a counter on it.
Yeah, you're not likely to.
It's an interesting card, I think.
Okay. It's certainly interesting,
In the chat, we have can confirm Gary Brown. Brendan's biggest fan, number 1, has joined the chat. So
hello, Brendan's biggest fan.
Hi. And
how's it going?
Thunderflux asks, what's your favourite non-bomb card?
I mean...
Does the bird count as a bomb?
I was going to say, it's a very good card.
I mean, I don't think this guy is a bomb.
I don't say he's necessarily a complete bomb. What we got?
Yes,
I think this guy's really cool.
Mm.
Renegade Rallier, if we can get him up.
There he is.
So, if you play turn two, you have a creature, then you could attack, offer a trade to your opponent, you trade the creatures, yours goes to the graveyard, turn three, you play your guy, get your creature back. I've done that a few times. Revolt is an interesting mechanic. It can be difficult to get off. I think in modern that could be great. Was it a Fatal Push?
Yeah, Fatal Push is pretty excellent.
That looks spicy.
This guy could be good in modern, because you can get... It's any permanent you can get back. You can get back a fetch land.
That is true. That
accelerates
your
mana.
Try to think best non-bomb.
Yeah, no, a Revolt does seem a lot stronger in modern. I'd be interested to see how easy it is to turn on in standard, given that we don't have fetch lands.
I don't know. I think Fatal Push could be good, because a lot of black decks might run... Evolving Wilds anyway, which counts as for the Revolt.
Yeah.
So I think at least a sideboard card is standard, if not mainboard. And modern should just be all day. mainboard, I should think. What is very good? The Rhino Train. I don't know if you guys have seen that.
Yeah,
much.
Dino Train.
Is it Dino?
Rhino too. Yeah, like, it's... I mean, we've been told via chat that Dino
it
Train.
It does look like a Triceratops.
Yes.
But it does also look like a
rhinoceros.
So
either or.
True. Because it's obviously similar to the Renegade Freighter from last set, which was insane. Crew 1 on a 4-4 trample, which gets counters, is... That is a bomb, I mean, I think, in Limited at least.
Mm. It's super good, right?
Yeah.
Superb.
Yeah, attacks at a 5-5. Jeez, yeah, we've been...
Crew for 1.
Crew for 1 is... So like
strong,
so infinitely, so much infinitely better than Crew 2.
Yeah, just a servo, right? Like
yeah, exactly. Yeah. Just a servo. It's so good.
As that is time on the round, I might see if I can go grab Jason quickly.
Yeah, go for it. Yeah,
you guys can continue talking. I think there's been more things on the chat if you're interested.
What we got?
It looks like you're being trolled slightly. I imagine.
GG's in the chat.
Yeah, Zafri 7 does make the good point about Oath of Gideon. You can play turn 3 Gideon many other ways anyway.
True. But then, are mana docks necessarily going to be in a sort of deck Gideon might be? Because Gideon's in really aggro decks. Yeah. Are mana docks aggro? Maybe. But that's a valid point. That train is strong, Thunderflux. Very, very strong. I mean, what can you do to it, right? Vehicles, you can't even destroy target creature with a sorcery speed because they're an artifact, they're not a creature. Vehicles are good. Smuggler's Copter gets banned, that's why. What's the best thing you've ever done in a car park?
You don't have to answer all the questions in the chat, just to put it out there. Just in case.
It's just car.
Oh yeah, welcome Jason.
Cool,
best
train. You can take my seat if you want.
This is the biggest train ever, man. Your budget. We liked your deck very much, Jason. Ooh. Thank you for letting us witness its awesome majesty.
Thank you.
That was a very big automaton.
Yeah, it was.
A lot of servos.
It was pretty nice. Cool.
But we'd like to present you, in honour of this, we'd like to present you
with a zebra.
With a zebra of awesomeness.
Well, thank you very much. I'm most proud
for the coolest, dirtiest
to thing.
We thought it was super cool.
Cool.
I wanted you to win in my heart, because it was awesome. Awesome.
You missed the other half of it. I had SRAM with the bouncing
aura
as well, yeah. And so I got that off a couple of times as well, which was hilarious.
cards.
Yeah. Well, thank you very much, guys. I appreciate
that's all right.
It.
We hope you treasure it.
I will do.
Bring it to next pre-release maybe as a good luck charm.
Yeah, I will, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
And cool. Just know that... At your soul, we think you're a zebra player.
Well, thank you very much. Cool. Right. Thanks, guys.
Thanks,
bye.
Jason. Bye. Thank you.
Bye.
All right.
Cool.
So,
awesome.
Switching it back to us. Should we wait to the standings? Do we want to go through the standings?
Yeah, we could do.
I guess so.
Would you guys like to hear the standings?
I mean, I think they're just finishing up the round now, so just be a couple of minutes. You just have to listen to us witter on about various things for a little while.
Kablamo Squeezer asks, what's the best thing I've ever done in a car park? And you?
I learned to ride a bike in the car park.
That's very cute.
That was cool.
It's the best thing I've ever done in a car park. That's such a... I feel like I must have done cool things in a car park.
We don't have to answer these questions, just so you know.
I know, but I want to.
Thunderflux, new black, destroy creature or vehicle. That'd be daring demolition. That is actually really useful. Vehicles are really annoying to get rid of, aren't they? So much sorcery speed removal that doesn't get rid of them. Multiple times earlier in the pre-release we had Caught in the Brights. We had four in one of our decks. You'd have multiple of those in hand, and then there'd be just a vehicle staring you down. And you're like, I can't Caught in the Brights every single one drop you play. Every single one. That's not gonna go well. Thank you very much.
Thanks, Zephyr.
Gary.
Gary, Zephyr. Like, I mean, I understand, like, it's quite cool to have your username spoken, I think, because you feel like a hacksaw, or at least I do. But then I'm really lame, so, like, you know.
I'm glad you enjoyed our stream.
Yeah.
I guess we're going to stream more stuff in future, so if you want to see us in particular, let us know. If you like the stream in general, that's cool.
Let us know.
we'll have, I guess, we'll probably take volunteers for the stream next time as well. That's what we did this time.
But yeah.
I guess we'll find out.
But yeah, it's been super cool having you along. Everyone who stayed from the start, it's been nice having people on the chat.
I just thought something. We don't know what the time of the round is. Or do we? It's
out
time.
Out of time.
It is time. Nice one.
And so do we, Brendan's biggest fan, number one.
But probably not quite as much.
And so do we.
Probably not quite as much as you.
No. Don't think anyone does. You're the number one fan.
Nice. So, do you think we'll get any packs for this commentary?
I think we deserve at least 12.
I don't think we get anything.
Just have to be happy with your kind words, I suppose. No. That's really lovely.
This is surprisingly tiring, isn't it? Like you're talking constantly.
Yeah. I find it quite easy. But Kieran's the man with a lot of rules knowledge, so probably, you know, you're talking a lot more at some points.
Yeah, probably.
So but I'm used to talking a lot, so I guess that makes us good.
Nice. Well, do you want to go bug Jamie for what long we got left and whether we can get some standings? We'll read out the standings.
We'll tell you the standings.
Assuming it's not going to be too long. Brendan obviously is on 12 points, but there was another person on 9 points playing on table 2. So there may be a tie for first place, or it may come down to tiebreakers. Here we go. Let's look at some more cards. I guess. These things, wow, they're nuts. Good for Living End, maybe? If you draw Living End, you can cast it with this.
Okay, well, we're still on turns.
They're still on turns. Okay, so it's going to be a few minutes. We're on the stream. We may as well carry on. We've got nowhere to be, except home. You know.
You know.
Living lives.
Quiet, miserable flat.
Dying Christmas tree.
Really, we don't have a car. We've just got a Christmas tree that's never ever gonna see the tip. We're gonna be like one of those weirdos who keeps their Christmas tree up till summer out of pure laziness.
If anyone has any promo foil metallic mimics, I still need two. So if you're in Norwich and you want to trade it, then let me know. Gotta try the merfolk. It might not be any good, but I'll try it. I may as well get the promos.
You
shiny.
You joke, Thunderflux, or maybe you don't, but yeah, staring at cards is pretty fun.
We never got to see anyone do this. To have to draft
Crew
either
six,
or have to either a revolt to draft a bit and then see if it ever happens.
Maybe there's a way to do it in constructed.
There is
maybe.
The wombo combo.
That's super cool.
And then you get a giant 7/11. Without
Girl
trample?
For one free mana. One mana.
Yeah, 7/11, no trample though.
Yeah, which makes it a lot less good.
Yeah, indeed. This guy's weird.
So, who is here's a question. Who is your favourite character from Kaladesh, not card-based, but personality, flavour text, flavour-based, story-wise?
I have not read the stories for Kaladesh.
Well, I think Yeheni's really cool, so what...
Oh yeah, two aerial modification on. Whew. That is nice. Where is aerial modification? Let's find it. Then you can have a flying giant boat.
There he is.
Though yo, 5 mana. Vehicle becomes a creature. Gets +2/+2 in flying.
Made it a 9/13 flyer. Bonkers, my friend. That is bonkers. Don't mind if I do. Then swapped it with a Fopter.
Nice. There's another one. Siege modification. Then you can have
using
a 10/11 first strike.
How very shrewd of you.
That's a pretty good bargain. You ripped someone off there. I'd quite like to make the steal stuff, sacrifice it kind of deck.
I'd quite like all their creatures to that card for the art. Like, what an awesome picture. Just like, that's really cool, right? Like Jack-in-the-Box Gremlin, don't mind if I do.
Yeah, you could combine it in draft or whatever with, say, something like this guy, Emberall Gear Smasher.
Yeah.
Sack an artifact to do 2 damage to each opponent, which is super good in Two-Headed Giant, but we didn't get to...
That was the thing, like when we were looking at our Two-Headed Giant deck, we were thinking about using this with filigree... I want to say Filigree Fox, but it's not called that. Filigree Familiar?
Yeah. 3 mana 2/2.
And other such things where you get your value, then smash it to bits. Not that I'd ever want to smash a fox to bits, but super cool. Would be super cool.
Don't smash up foxes.
I love foxes. I'd never do such a thing. Can I have a look, please, at the Circles Gear Man up?
Oh,
this
we got
thank you, and I am going to go.
Thank you, Jamie.
Okay.
All right, in our most dramatic voices.
This is my most dramatic voice.
Sorry, that's a little bit boring there, Rachel. Yeah.
This is my most dramatic voice. Is that better?
So we had 24 players in this pre-release. So from the bottom, shall we alternate?
All right, so in a 24th place.
We have Jamie Falkart.
In 23rd place, it was Mr. Moore.
We had on stream.
We did have him on stream. He didn't get that 13 mana combo off.
No.
Which apparently didn't exist anyway. Anyway.
Mm-hmm. In 22nd place, we have Ian Sell.
Woo! Hype. In 21st place, we have Daniel Robinson.
In 20th place, we have Dominic Raybould. Woo-hoo. His name shall forever be immortalized on Twitch.
In 19th place was Lu Chu.
In 18th place, we have Cass Barrett.
Whoop. In 17th place, it's Bailey Yates.
Woo. In 16th place, we have Ziggy Cook.
Whoop, whoop, whoop.
Well done, Ziggy.
In 15th place, our favourite artifacts, Dirdle King.
Zebra Guy.
Yeah, Zebra Guy, Jason Hurd.
Then up in 14th, we have Sergio Rodriguez.
Whoop. 13th was Todd Heron.
More than Todd. In 12th place, we have James Wiley.
Whoop. In 11th place, we have Jamie Pope.
The Game Day Champion. In 10th place, we have Ross Hewitt.
Whoop. In 9th place, we have Matt Horn with his red-white elves.
Or red-white vehicles?
Elf vehicles.
Dude, where's my car?
Yeah.
In 8th place, we have Yohiro Futamata. Nice one.
In 6th place is Kyle Spencer.
I skipped 7th.
No, I've skipped 7th. In 7th place is Kalam Motin.
6th place, Kyle Spencer, though I feel like that was stolen from me.
Sorry. You can do the next one if you like to make up for it.
In 5th place, we have Ian Drew.
Whoop. In 4th place is James Slater.
So, deck did pretty well in the end, huh? He went 3-0. That's James Gurney is above him. He was in third place. My mistake. That's third place, James
Gurney. In second place, silver medalist is Andrew Clayton.
Ah, cool. Who we saw on stream. And then our winner is Brendan Edwards.
Whoop!
Well done, Brendan. I have been Kieren. This has been...
Rachael.
This has been Athena Games' pre-release stream for Aether Revolt. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm wondering now, did Elliot tell me how to turn off the stream? I don't know.
We could just be here forever!
So I'm going to try and turn off the stream. Thanks for tuning in, everyone.
Yeah, see you later.
See you around. Ooh.